Yes, good morning YouTube. So I've been working on my Type A Machines Series 1 Pro 3D printer, and this is the way it comes. It's an open build volume, so you've got the metal frame, and it's got these plexiglass kind of decorating panels. And one thing I was thinking would be a good idea is to make an enclosure for the print volume. And on the sides, I guess one thing you could probably do is cut a piece of plexiglass the full size and put that in place. But I have these scraps of 5/16 inch or 8 millimeter double wall polycarbonate panel that I used on my patio roof and walls. So I had some strips of these. So there's these spacers that space the decorative panels off of the metal frame. They were a little bit under 8 millimeters, and this is a little bit over 8 millimeters, so I just stuck in an extra washer, and then I cut some notches to fit around the spacers, and I can drop a panel in there, and let's see if I can get it up here. It's basically a friction fit, and then I cut another panel, and then this guy, I just basically cut these things to fit in here. And there we go. We got a panel enclosure on that side. And if we spin it around, you can see I've got the other side enclosed. And then for the front, I had another scrap of material. I did not even cut this. This was the scrap as I had it on my scrap pile. And I mean, it's like I measured and cut this piece to fit, but I didn't. This came off the scrap pile. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to embed a couple of magnets down in here and just have the magnets hold that on the front, because this, I think, is steel. And yeah, I'll just have to leave access to the power button. I think I have access there. And then I had another scrap. Literally, this is the way it came off my scrap pile. And that one fits right up on top to give this a little bit of working room for the filament, because you see the filament has to come in and arc over there. What I'm gonna do is put a couple of 2x2s up on top there. So let me go grab one of those and show you. Okay, so what I'm gonna do to give me a little bit of height here is I've got a couple of scrap 2x2s. These came from my last shipping crate, and I just want to build a simple frame around the front here. In fact, I'll probably slide those back, put that across the front, and then I'll put this piece on top here. Actually, my plan, instead of having the spool up on top like that, is I want to have my filament spools in a separate airtight container with desiccant in it, and I'll just actually feed a tube with the filament up and back. And the only way the top is going to be attached, you can see there's these screws that hold the rails in place. And what I'll do is just drill little recesses on the wood so that that registers over these screw heads. That way this will register right on top, and that's just going to sit up there. So that's all repurposed material. The other thing is I do not have to drill or do any modifications to the printer itself. Everything just drops in place, slides in existing gaps, and that way I'll have a totally enclosed build volume. And then with the clear sides, that'll let light in from outside. But I also plan on putting some LED strip lighting inside here. So I'm going to have some 12 volt LED strip lights. I'll probably put lights around the top here, because this printer does have the webcam built in. If we move over here, I'll show you that. Kind of hard to see. It's out of the way here, but right there is a little webcam that stream video of the printing process, because my printer will be up in the attic, and my plan is to just start a print and then I can watch the video stream and make sure it's all going okay. But if it's printing for 12 hours, I don't necessarily want to go up and check on it all the time. So that's one reason I bought this printer, because it has the built-in webcam and the built-in Wi-Fi access. Okay, so I'll give you a shot of this once I get a little farther on. I want to try my magnets on here, because this is, I think it's all steel construction. And I think with the magnets or the Velcro, that'll be nice, because I can just take the whole front off if I need to. And I can also just lift the top off if I need access to the bed. And there's no tools required to install this. Everything just fits in place, and the front will stick on with magnets. The sides just slip fit into the existing decorative panels, and then the top will just sit on top with gravity holding it down. And the idea of doing this, one is when I'm running a heated bed, this will keep the heat trapped inside to some degree, so it doesn't take as much energy to keep the bed hot. Because right now, when it's cold and the air is circulating, it's constantly cooling that bed down, so the bed heater has to run more, and that uses more power. And then the other thing is, for plastics that shrink and warp quite a bit, like ABS and nylon, I think it would be nice to have the sealed bed. So here's what happens when an ABS part cools. I don't know if that'll show up there in the light. You can see I had good bed adhesion. The bottom of this case stuck to the bed, but there was such stress as the upper layers cooled, they pulled away from the bottom layers. As I understand it, with ABS, if you can have an enclosed build volume that stays reasonably hot, this warping tends to be less. So I guess one way to find out is to try it. So that's my plan, is I want to enclose this build volume. And I'll show you what it looks like when I get done. And then one other thing, this is the plastic panel I have, and you can see there's this protective film on. And unfortunately, I left this outside quite a while, and this film has become quite brittle. It's really hard to peel off. I found a really handy trick for getting that stuff off, and I'll show you that here in a little bit. So, stay tuned for updates on this project as I get it finished, and I'll show you what it looks like a little later. Thanks for watching.